Okay, I just wanted to say it's 44 degrees, and I'm starting to pull the system out. So, I'm halfway in my garage, so hopefully it doesn't get too cold.
Got a little bit of mat right there. I got a lot of bit of mat right here. No, wait, 80 pounds. The 80 pound rule of fiberglass. So, watch for that. Okay, I got the box out of the trunk now. Really tiny box. Here's what the trunk looks like. You know, normal trunk. Just got a little extra wood in it right now. The box is actually 4.6 net. I don't know what it's tuned to. You can measure that up, but yeah, 4.6. So these clubs are kind of suffocating in this little box. But, oh well. Okay, I know I said I had the worst ground known to man, but here's the proof. All this ground on that one little block, that's a problem. Okay, I'm just test fitting the batteries right now, kind of seeing how they're going to fit in the spare tire well. This guy is going to be gone. I'm going to use these guys. So hopefully that should work. Help. Here's some of my goodies for the install. 0, 4, more 0, more 4, and some 8 that I'm going to use for from the amps to the set. And some terminals, and some other little goodies. Yeah. Now, the good thing about cars or any vehicle that has the trunk in the back, or the battery in the back of the trunk, this is all of the power cable that I use for the whole car. And keep in mind, each one of those amps has an extra power and an extra ground. So there's two extra wires in there that for a smaller amp you wouldn't need if you're just trying to do something small, or you're not going to be upgrading the electrical system or doing a big tree. And you're not going to have to spend much on power cable, but it's actually going to hurt me in the long run. Not really hurt me, it doesn't really matter, but doing the big three, because you're going to have to run, you know, your cable from the alternator to the trunk, and then your negative from the battery up to the engine block, so you're using about an extra 50 feet that you wouldn't have to use. But if you're just doing something smaller, just for a little bump, then you're not going to have to use much cable. Okay, I just took some measurements in the trunk. I'm thinking I can fit 15 by 35 by 32, which comes out to 9.7 cubic feet before displacement. So it might drop down to somewhere closer to 9.2 with the port displacement and everything else. But I guess we'll just have to see.